it's maybe a little bit more tasteful than our last sound that we just did.
Yeah,
so.
It may be my favourite out of all these.
Now this is yours as well, isn't it?
Yeah, so this is a Dimension C DC-2 pedal. There's quite an interesting history with this. It derives from the SDD-320 rack module. So it was very similar to the panel on this, where it just had four buttons and it made your sound infinitely better.
Yeah, absolutely, that's the best way to put it. Cut it at that.
With no description of what is going on with these buttons, there's so much intricacy in how the waveforms are being adjusted and modulation is changing that the designers at Roland and Boss just thought, you know what, we're going to give you four and you just need to deal with it. This quite often gets described as being a chorus, but it's not really a chorus pedal. It's kind of just adding space. It's almost like a psychosomatic trick.
Right, okay.
So if you could do me a favour, if you could play some chords.
Certainly.
Clean, we're just going to look at the original right now, the DC-2. I'm just going to have it clean and I'm just going to add in the effect.
Perfect. More subtle, certainly, than the CE2, which could get obviously really wobbly at a point.
Yeah, but wobble being the word. So they use, I've been practicing this, a trapezoidal waveform.
You nailed it. I can confirm you nailed it.
That waveform, I'm not really into that kind of stuff, but apparently negates the wobble.
Right.
So that's what keeps it from being like pitch changing like choruses.
Yeah, yeah.
But to just making the space sound bigger. So we're running this in mono, but it sounds like the money is when you put it in stereo.
Even wider, if that was possible.
Honestly, if you ever have a chance and you're in headphones and you're playing your mono guitar and then you turn this on in stereo, you go from your guitar signal to poof. But it's so subtle though that on gigs I've put it on and forgot. You know, and then three songs later, you're like, oh
my word.
This has been on the whole time. Yeah. But it's that subtle. So I like it a lot because you can actually sneak it into more things. Whereas a chorus, it's very obvious when you have a chorus on.
Definitely.
It's by no means bad, but you are playing a chorus sound and then that kind of pigeonholes you sometimes to having a 80s style modulation sound.
Absolutely. Because this, obviously, with the Dimension C, not only does it give you that space and that kind of, you know, that you could classify that as in the same wheelhouse as a chorus, so you can get those like sparkly nice arpeggio chords and, you know, all that sort of stuff. But for the practical use of this, you could use it, say, to even like widen your solo out. You know, you could use this to just make your rhythm guitar sound bigger than it is.
Yeah, well, that was the intention. Yeah. You know, when it was first designed, the rack's been around for a long time. On the rack there's a kind of secret setting where you could press two of the buttons at the same time. You can't do that on this one. So on this, these are like mechanical dials. When I press number four, it goes in. And there's nothing to tell me that it's on number four other than that it's pressed in.
Yeah.
Whereas when we go to the modern version, the Waza, they've put these little LEDs. And it's such a simple thing, but I've played both on gigs. And there's been so many times between songs I've went, let me just double check I'm on the right setting. Because you can also not plug them in. And it's like passive. But if you want to play it for me, just again, this is clean.
So still does something.
So even when they're not engaged in a setting, something's happening, which is quite interesting in itself. But again, you sometimes on a gig accidentally nudge it and you go to hit three and you just knock it out or whatever. But it's an awesome pedal. It's so simple. So the Waza version, I forget the exact date. I think it's 2016-17 era. This is in standard mode, replicating this the best it can, like I say, with these little LED lights indicating which we're on, which I think is like a really simple feature, but like I just spoke about, it's really invaluable when you're on a gig.
Yeah.
So we'll hear this one for a bit and then I'll show you guys the SDD-320 as well.
Cool.
Adding some delay that is built into the amp using the GAFCEX switcher. And as you might be able to see from the camera, we've engaged two settings at once. So I've got 1 and 4 both engaged, just like on the original. Mm-hmm. So I think that means that you end up with 20 different variations you can have, whereas on the original you can have there's four. You know, so
it's a lot more.
You're getting a lot for your money. Not only several pedals in the one, but you're all these variations just out of four switches is crazy.
Yeah, and then the custom mode, like I alluded to, is the original SDD320 setting. So we'll put that on. So similar to when we were comparing the CE1 and the CE2, a little bit kind of thicker and more lush, because when these things get converted into compact pedals, the parts are smaller, the circuits are smaller, all that kind of stuff. So again, in the 80s when this was designed, they had to make compromises, but today the technology is so good, we can get that original SDD sound as well as the Dimension C sound. Yeah, it's great. This is kind of famously used on Purple Rain. The main guitar part you hear, everyone says it was a SDD, but I did watch an interview with Wendy Melvoin recently, and she said it was a CE1 or a CE2.
Oh.
So there's a lot of kind of misinformation out there. I think it sounds good on either.
I mean, it's...
it's a B-flat with some dimension chorus, and that's it.
That's all you need to do, to be fair. And, I mean, it's... for me, certainly, it's the coolest colour on any Waza Crafts as well. Like, I can't deny that all these look awesome, but it's just something about that purple looks amazing. So, yeah. Or lilac, I guess you would call that one. But yeah, this is, I think you put it best when it first started, that it just makes everything sound good, which is the kind of the fun thing about the Dimension C, is just, you don't need to really explain exactly what it does, it just makes it sound good.